Hi there, ladies and gentlemen. It's me, Dr. Donna. Can you believe we're at week 33? Without further ado, check out what I have for you. Last week, I read Taking Charge. This book was long, and why was it so long? Because it accounted for almost the entire year of President Johnson taking over after the assassination of President Kennedy, from the first phone call he made all the way up until the end of August 1963. This book is about the one-year recording of Lyndon B. Johnson from the time of the unfortunate assassination of President John F. Kennedy up until the end of August 1964. Now, this book is 546 pages of nothing but telephone transcripts. I know I'm a glutton for punishment, right? But I want to read this information. Number one, because President Johnson died 5 months before I was born. But not only that, there was so much controversy about the assassination and him taking over and how he handled the situation. I really just wanted to see, you know me, I like getting it from the horse's mouth. What I found is that as a real leader, I put myself in Johnson's shoes and I said, well, what would I have done? The president of the United States has just been assassinated. You don't know if there's an assassination attempt on your life. You don't know what's going to happen in the country. Remember, we got problems with Cuba. Bay of the Pigs had just taken place. We have problems with Russia. What would you have done? Just think about that for a second. Would you be ready to stay in Dallas or would you be ready to leave? I don't know. I think I would have gotten on the plane and left as well and been ready to take care of America. And that is what Johnson did. Now, you can say that you liked him or you hated him, but during his year of presidency prior to running in 64, he had a lot to contend with. He's coming behind JFK, and that's a legacy that you want to protect. So how can you still honor the legacy of the president that you're preceding, that preceded you, and still be able to run the country? As you know, Johnson simply wanted to run for president in 1968. He had no idea that that would occur in 1963. You have the brother of the president who is now the attorney general, and you have to deal with that. And all of the Kennedy legacy and everybody that's already in place. How do you handle that? So before you say Johnson sucked or Johnson was the man, just think about it. If you were the vice president and all of that occurred in such a short period of time, right before Thanksgiving, right before the holidays, and Jacqueline had just lost a baby, just think about all of that and then say, what kind of decisions would I have made and would I have been so strong to be able to still hold the country intact? I don't know. I really don't know. There were three primary actions that took place, in my opinion, in 1964. Number one was the Revenue Act of 1964, which brought the tax cuts in, as well as a budget under $100 billion. Number two was the Civil Rights Act, which was signed on July 2, 1964. And number three was the Gulf of Tonkin. That was the act that said Lyndon B. Johnson can send troops to Southeast Asia without declaring war and without getting congressional approval. That is what kicked everything off for Vietnam, and as you know, we sent a lot more soldiers starting in 64, and it really didn't end well. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to say that if you have time and if you can put a 564-page book into your reading repertoire, go ahead and read this book because it is interesting for someone to be brave enough to publish this. And you have to remember that these tapes were not supposed to be released until 2023, but we had access to them much sooner. And it's just awesome to be able to read something like this. Check it out. Well, ladies and gentlemen, this week's book is Who Moved My Cheese, a classic among our book challenge. I can't wait to see what him and Haw and Snip and Scurry are up to this time. Well, that's my time, ladies and gentlemen. But before I get out of here, just remember, if it's possible for me, then it's possible for you. Watch what we do in 52. I'll see you guys next time. Adios.